It's the last slide, right? Search with Yepudu Opuko Udra Votami. How many of you heard it? Listen to this.
అత్యాచారాలు ఇన్ని రకాల అన్యాయాలు భయాలు దాపం చేసుకోవడం నేను తప్పుకోనేమో కొన్ని రావద్దు ఎందుకంటే నేను అదే వచ్చిన దాన్ని రాయలు ప్రతి మనిషి ఒక్కసారి అనుకోగలిగితే జీవితం పాపం చేసుకోవాలి ఆ తావు ముగింపుని తగ్గుతుందో కాకుండా కొనసాగడం ఒక దాని మీద కేంద్రీకరించాలి ఈ పక్క వాక్యం కావాలి
ఆయువంటూ ఉన్న వరకు చావు కూడా నెగ్గలేక శవము పైన గెలుపు తాటురా
ఎప్పుడు ఒప్పుకోరా ఓడని
క్లోజ్. హౌ డిడ్ యూ ఫీల్? హ్యావ్ యూ హర్ అబౌట్ ఇట్? హ్యావ్ యూ ఎవర్ హర్డ్ దట్ సాంగ్? ఇట్ వాజ్ నాట్ ఇట్ డి నాట్ కమ్ ఇన్ ఎనీ మూవీ యాక్చువల్లీ. ఓకే, సో దెర్ ఆర్ సో మెనీ ఇన్స్పిరేషనల్ సాంగ్స్. మేబీ ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ క్లాస్ ఐ విల్ గివ్ ఏ కలెక్షన్. ఐ హావ్ కలెక్టెడ్ సమ్ 30-40 సాంగ్స్ ఇన్ తెలుగు ఓన్లీ, ఇన్స్పిరేషనల్ సాంగ్స్. ఇఫ్ పాసిబుల్ ఐ విల్ గివ్ వన్ సిడి, రికార్డ్ దెమ్ అండ్ సివ్ దెమ్. బట్ వెన్ ఎవర్ యూ ఫీల్ డల్, లిసన్ టు దెమ్ సీరియస్లీ. దట్ విల్ చేంజ్ యువర్ మైండ్, బికాస్ ఐ డూ ద సేమ్ థింగ్. Sometimes we keep running, sometimes there are some disappointments, sometimes there are pleasures, everything will be there, but how to keep yourself in fire, that's more important, right? Now, we'll discuss one case which every one of you know about him, of course. He was an engineer by profession and he was brought up in an environment where he was observing the society, he wanted to do something to the society, particularly to the orphans. I was talking about 1970s and 60s after his thought process. He wanted to start an orphanage at a very young age itself, but he himself did not settle down. He had got very high visions, high lofty goals, deep thinking about the society, to do something. He was an engineer, as I said. He don't want to get into a job. He wanted to start his own business, and his relatives were laughing. What the fun? Because that was an era when starting a business was equal to a journey to hell in India particularly. Economy did not open up, economic reforms were not introduced. It was in the 1980s, there was a license rush. For everything you had to run with ample departments to get the permissions, which was discouraging the people to get into entrepreneurship, get into business. And that was the time he decided to get into business. Okay. And he came across one girl who liked his passion for life, who liked his goals, who liked his thinking, and she was already working with a company, and she has got a different story that I will tell you at the later point. And she liked him and they got married. After that, they started working for a company. Probably Jagdish were guessing him out, right? Both of them were working. After 3 or 4 years, he came to his wife and said, I want to start a business. She did not disgrace him. But she gave 10,000 rupees from their savings and asked him to start the business. But she kept only one condition. If you are going to fail within 3 years, you have to come back and join a job. Okay. He, along with his 5 friends, started the business. Total 6 people started the business. There was no business coming in. There were no contracts coming in. There were no companies coming in. It was a struggle. And from 1980 to 1983, there was no customers. In 1984, they got one customer, and from there was no looking back. And again, coming to 1990, the same boardroom kind of stuff, the 6 people were meeting, the 5 people were sitting, and the person whom we are talking about was expected for the meeting. The reason is that the company was going pretty well, and one US multinational company wanted to buy their company for $1 million. So they were very happy. Boss, we are going to sell the company, we are going to get out of the business, take our pie, take our share and get out. He said and sat in the chair, he started talking. The first statement he said, I don't want to sell the company, which shocked his partners. Why? So we started from nowhere, we started from scratch, we are here, and if we continue, we are going to be somewhere. I don't want to sell my company. But still, if you persist, because you are all equal partners, you have your own right to say, you have your own right to compel me to sell the company. If that is the case, I am going to buy this company from you, but I am not that rich to buy the company. Give me an opportunity. These 2 lines changed the minds of his partners. They all said, we are going to be with you. Let us go ahead. We don't sell this company. Now, can you guess that company? Excellent. Right? And that company has made more than 2,000 people as crorepatis and more than 20,000 people as lakhs. It has created employment for 25,000 people. And the leading technology company, I don't have to tell much about it. And I was talking about his wife, Mrs. Sudha Murthy, the gentle lady. Do you know how she got the job? She used to work in Tata Group companies. But do you know how she got the job? One day there was an advertisement in newspapers that there are openings in a Tata Group company, the two in Pune. I think it is Tata Motors, I don't remember the company, Tata Motors or Tata Telco. But there was a note below the advertisement that women should not apply. She wrote a postcard which was maybe 10 paisa or 5 paisa that day directly to JRT Tata, Jahangir Ratanji Tata. How many of you know him? The grandfather of Ratan Tata. How many of you know him? JRT Tata. She directly wrote a letter and she forgot about that. But that old gentleman, friends, how small habits make some difference. She never thought that she would get a return for that letter, she would get a rejoinder for that letter. But one day she got a letter from JRT Tata, that is the call letter for an interview. She went and met the Mr. Tata. He asked, of course, she was quite impressed for her boldness. She straight away asked, Why are you keeping women aside? Is that your company's policy? We all have a lot of respect for Tata Group companies. And the discussion went on and she got a job. Mr. Tata was impressed with her. And the same lady, when Infosys was started in its early days, she used to do her job, and in the evening time she used to come to the company and work for Infosys, Dr. Sudha Murthy. I think her autobiography is already available. Okay, I'm not sure. Okay. This is one example which is relevant to you technology guys. Okay. So you want to go ahead another story, or you want to stop now? What? Feeling, huh?
Go ahead.
Chris, his name, he was 8 years old when he was seeing his mother somewhere outside. But he could not approach her because it was a cemetery. Cemetery and idea on the smasanam. It was a cemetery and she was in the surveillance of police because she was arrested for the charge of a murder. And he was growing in a relative's place. He wanted to approach his mother and hug her, but he could not do that. She came to attend a funeral of one of their relatives passed away. Okay, Chris met her there in the cemetery. Chris grew up here and there in his relative's homes. He finished his graduation, he got a small job, and he got married and gave birth to a child. With inadequate and insufficient salary, his wife lost interest and she left. That is quite normal in US, right? He lost his job too with depression. And without any residence to stay, he used to stay in public places. He is already having a child by that time, and his child was with him. His kid was with him. And on a rainy day, they could not find any shelter. They rested in public toilets. The whole day when it was raining, they rested in public toilets. But with so many experiences, he never lost hope. With lots of efforts, he could find a job in a small brokerage firm. You know what is brokerage firm? A stockbroking firm, right? And he joined his son in daycare. Slowly, after gaining experience, Chris started his own business. Okay, that's one story. After some years, he heard a voice, "Sir, Mr. Thabo Mbeki wants to meet you." He said, "For sure," and moved forward. And he's none other than Chris, Christopher Gardner. His original name is Christopher Gardner. His associate, his secretary came to him and asked, "Mr. Thabo Mbeki wants to meet you." And who is Thabo Mbeki? He is the president of South Africa. The guy who rested in public toilets, he started a business, developed a company, and the South African appointment was seeking appointment. The South African president was seeking appointment. From where to where? Right? And Christopher Gardner is the president of a big financial company. Thabo Mbeki was the president for South Africa. That was the same Chris who we talked about in the previous state. And a movie was made on his story. If you have any chance, see this, The Pursuit of Happiness. Note down his name. Will Smith. The Pursuit of Happiness, English movie. See this movie. Because even I haven't seen it, I will also see. Again, before the class ends, we will have a small discussion on that. So what do you feel again? The same answer here. Every story has the same answer. Never give up. Never give up. Never recognize problems. Never compromise with circumstances. All the three bottom lines. Do you find anything additional in this story? Any additional qualities that made him big? But to start enterprise, obviously he requires some kind of planning, some kind of commitment, some kind of confidence, all these qualities also there. But compared to other stories, he is lucky. Because why I say, he is not suffering from any kind of physical disability. His health is perfect. And starting a business from zero level is not a big deal actually, if you are going in a proper direction. Even in India, you can do that. If you are interested, even you can today start small business and you can make it big down the line 5 to 6 years. That is not a big deal. Only thing is that you need to have proper maturity to handle the business. But why one suggests to have some experience before getting into business is that you will come to know how people react, how people act, how to manage people. That's the reason yesterday I suggested all of you to take some membership in any one of the social organizations like Lions Club, Rotary Club, or Jesse's, or maybe if you are having any potential clubs in your Java, .NET or something like that, you become a partner of them. And one suggestion I can make you, there is one activity called Toastmasters. Have you heard about it, any one of you? Toastmasters? No. Toastmaster is one, otherwise known as master of ceremony, who organizes a meeting. If you go to a meeting, you see a person who keeps on coordinating the meeting, inviting the guests, introducing the guests to the public, defining the agenda of the meeting, defining the schedule, describing the schedule, and coordinating it. He is called a master of ceremony actually. And this master of ceremony requires some kind of good communication skills and good body language to conduct these kind of programs. And to develop such kind of skills, there is one club called Toastmasters Club. In Hyderabad, there are so many Toastmaster clubs. Every month they meet once. You just try to join there. That would improve your communication, that would improve your confidence level, that would improve your body language. And just read about it, Toastmaster, write down, TOASTMASTER, Toastmasters, Hyderabad Toastmasters, you can write it down. And that meeting every month, second Sunday, it takes in Amirpet, in Dharmakaran Road. You can just find the address in their website. There is one studio called Jikyasa Studio, JIJYASA. They won't allow you to become the member unless and until you attend 3 meetings. There are very strict rules into that. But once you get into it, it's wonderful. And there are so many clubs, not only Hyderabad Toastmasters, there is one Madhapur Toastmasters Club, there is one Jubilee Toastmasters, like that. There are so many clubs in India. Any club you can join. What they do? They speak on various topics. You see people talking on various topics. And that really helps you to improve your communication, your body language, everything. Okay. To find out the meeting schedule, there is one site called meetup.com. M-E-E-T-U-P. Meetup.com/Hyderabad. Go to Google, meetup.com and Hyderabad. He was born in a small village to a strong couple, but he was short and weak. His parents were quite, what you call them?
Bulge.
What?
Bulge.
Yeah, not bulge. Ajan Bahul Telugu. Actually, but ayana vachese putta aina, okay,
stout,
he was stout. Maybe he has got it, maybe his grandfather's genes or grandmother's genes, whatever it is. Day one, when he entered the school, he sat in the first bench along with one Brahmin student. His name was some Ram Mohanachar, something like, I don't remember. But when the that irritated his master, because this guy with his craft, you know, Abul Kalam gar ela untaru telusu ayana craft ayana avataram chusi పొద్దున మాస్ మన పొంతుల గారికి లోపలికి వెళ్ళగానే చిరాకు వచ్చింది, ఏంటో పొద్దున వీడంటే అడవమోహన్. సో ఓకే, దట్ వాస్ హీ ఫెల్ట్ యాక్చువల్ ఒరిజినల్ ఫీలింగ్, ఐఎమ్ నాట్ సెయింగ్ దట్ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ద మెస్ అండ్ ఆస్క్డ్ హిమ్ టు గో అండ్ సిట్ ఇన్ ద బ్యాక్ బెంచ్. దట్ రియలీ హర్టెడ్ హిమ్, ఆబ్వియస్లీ దట్ హ్యాపన్స్. అండ్ దీస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్సెస్ హీ ఫేస్డ్ లాట్ ఇన్ హిస్ లైఫ్. హీ యూస్ టు గో టు హిస్ సమ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ హౌస్, పర్టికులర్లీ తమిళ్, యు నో దెర్ వాస్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ అయ్యంగార్ డామినేషన్. అయ్యంగార్ బిలాంగ్స్ టు బ్రాహ్మిన్ కమ్యూనిటీ, అయ్యంగార్స్ ఇన్ ద సెన్స్ బ్రాహ్మిన్స్. దెర్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ అయ్యంగార్ డామినేషన్ ఇన్ తమిళ్. వెన్ హీ యూస్ టు గో టు ఇన్ అయ్యంగార్స్ హౌస్, the ladies in those houses were not interested in serving food for him. And even if they served, they used to wash their hands with, as well as wash the vessels completely. That kind of untouchability was practiced in those days, and he was a victim of all this untouchability. He suffered a lot. And there was no proper guidance for his education. He never knows, you know, he wasted some time. He did his graduation just for the sake of doing the graduation. After that, he went for a post-graduation, but professional studies. But what I mean to say is, instead of doing directly a BTEC, he first did some BCom and then did a BTEC kind of stuff. He nearly wasted 3 years for the time. And he wanted to join Indian Air Force after completing his professional examinations. But he was rejected in Indian Air Force because of his again physical problem, personal personality problem. But today, where is he? Where is he? I don't have to tell you, right? Yeah. Behind the revolution, missile revolution. He was the man behind the missile revolution in India. He was the man behind the nuclear energy generation in India. Everything. And I think of all the presidents, he was the best president in India. The best utilization of the presidential roles Abdul Kalam has written, none other has done. Okay, ఇప్పుడు ఉన్నారు ఎవరు ప్రెసిడెంట్ గారు ఏం మాట్లాడతాం ఏం మాట్లాడకూడదు ఓకే దట్ వాజ్ హిస్ కోట్ ఎక్వస్ ఎంతమంది చదివారు ఆయన బయోగ్రఫీ ఆయన బుక్స్ రెండు మూడు ఉన్నాయి యాక్చువల్గా తెలుగులో ఎంతమంది చదివారు థింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫైర్ ఎంతమంది చదివారు ఇంగ్లీష్లో సార్ ఇంగ్లీష్ సబ్జెక్టా గ్రేట్ 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 సో దట్ వాజ్ అ కంపల్షన్ యూ రైట్ ఇట్ అదర్వైజ్ నాట్ సార్ మార్క్స్ తగ్గుతాయి కాబట్టి ఎనీవే డిస్పైర్ డిప్రెషన్ అండ్ సాడ్నెస్ ఆర్ పార్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ లైఫ్ వన్ హ్యాస్ టు జస్ట్ కౌంటర్ అండ్ సప్రెస్ దెమ్ అండ్ ట్రావెల్ టువర్డ్స్ ఫ్యూచర్ ఓకే దట్స్ ఓకే సో హౌ డూ ఫీల్ అబౌట్ ద సెషన్ ఓవరాల్ ఐ వాంట్ సమ్ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ హౌ డూ ఫీల్ యూ ఫీల్ హ్యాపీ సాడ్ యూ ఎక్స్పెక్టెడ్ సంథింగ్ ఎల్స్ మోటివేటెడ్ ఓకే డిడ్ యూ లైక్ ఐ మీన్ డిడ్ యూ లైక్ దిస్ యూ వాంట్ టు హ్యావ్ సిమిలర్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ సెషన్స్ ఎ కపుల్ ఆఫ్ అదర్ సెషన్స్ నోట్ మోర్ బికాస్ వీ హ్యావ్ వెరీ లెస్ టైమ్ మేబీ వన్ మోర్ సెషన్ ఐ విల్ హ్యావ్ ఓకే ఓకే గుడ్ మీకు ఎడ్యుకేషన్లో రిజర్వేషన్స్ ఉన్నాయి మాట్లాడటం లేదు యూ హ్యావ్ టు స్పీక్ అవుట్ ఓన్లీ హౌట్ ఓన్లీ 33% ఇన్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ నాట్ ఇన్ స్పీకింగ్ అవుట్ యా ఇన్స్పిరేషన్ సాంగ్స్ ఇన్ తెలుగు కమ్ ఆన్ వాట్స్ యువర్ ఫీలింగ్ వాట్స్ యువర్ నేమ్ ఫోగట్ మనోహర్ వాట్స్ యువర్ ఫీలింగ్ దిస్ సాంగ్ వాజ్ ఆల్సో ఏ ప్రైవేట్ సాంగ్ ఇట్ వాజ్ రిటర్న్ బై వన్ పర్సన్ విప్లవ్ సేన్ టు డెడికేట్ హిస్ టు హిస్ మెమరీ ఆఫ్ హిస్ నెఫ్యూ హూ డైడ్ ఎట్ ఎ వెరీ యంగ్ ఏజ్ సాయిరామ్ నెలుట్ల హ్యావ్ యూ హర్డ్ ద సాంగ్ ఎనీ టైమ్ ఓకే చెప్పండి బట్ కోటేశ్వరావు వాట్ ఈస్ యువర్ ఫీలింగ్ ఈజ్ ఇట్ యూస్ఫుల్ ఓకే కమ్ ఆన్ ప్లే ద సాంగ్ హియర్
రాజసమేయాన పాలు ఒడి దూరుకులకెదిరేగే సత్వము
How is it? Wonderful? Awesome? There is a reason for showing this video at the end of the session. If you observe, there were some lines coming when he was singing the song, right? మనం ఇప్పుడు దాకా డిస్కస్ చేసిన అన్ని స్టోరీస్లో ఏవైతే ఫ్యాక్టర్స్ ఉన్నాయో మొత్తం అక్కడ ఉన్నాయి దాంట్లో. ఒకసారి వీడియో మళ్ళీ ప్లే చేసి ఒక చిన్న మీకు చూపిస్తాను. ఇన్స్పిరేషనల్ వీడియో సాంగ్స్, తెలుగు సాంగ్స్, ఇన్స్పిరేషనల్ సాంగ్స్ తెలుగు, జస్ట్ టైప్ నో ఇష్యూస్. ఇన్స్పిరేషనల్ సాంగ్స్ తెలుగు. See, you can see how many views? 52,691 views, right? When I first observed this video some 7-8 months back, there were only 3,000 views. Okay, chinna parody, not to discourage anyone, but manam actually internet ela vaadukuntam anedhi ani kochina example. Neri enna unna views? Very short time, 1,41,000 views. Tara Chowdhury video. అదే నాట్ టు డిస్క్రైమ్, బట్ మన ఇంటర్నెట్ ఎలా వాడుకుంటాం దానికి ఎగ్జాంపుల్ నేను మీకు చూపించాను అంతే. ఇట్స్ అ వండర్ఫుల్ రిసోర్స్ గైస్ ఇంటర్నెట్, అండ్ ప్రాపర్గా వాడుకుంటే ఇట్ కెన్ టేక్ అ సమ్వేర్, ఎవ్రీథింగ్ యూ విల్ బి అవైలబుల్. ఇది సిక్స్, ఇది యాక్చువల్గా తారా చౌదరి ఎపిసోడ్ జరిగి హార్డ్లీ 3 weeks అయిందో 4 weeks అయిందో, ఓకే హార్డ్లీ 3 weeks అయిందో 4 weeks అయింది, యూ కెన్ సీ ద వ్యూస్. బట్ ద సేమ్ కేస్ విత్ దిస్ పర్టికులర్ సాంగ్. నేను నా ఫేస్బుక్లో చాలామంది పోస్ట్ చేశాను ఆ సాంగ్, వెన్ ఐ సా ఐ ఫెల్ట్ రియల్లీ బ్యాడ్. 3,000 వ్యూస్, వాట్ హెక్. తర్వాత ఈ 6 మంత్స్లో మేబీ చూసిన వాళ్ళు ఇంకా పోస్ట్ చేసుకుంటూ వెళ్ళుంటారు. ఇప్పుడు రైట్ అవుట్ ఇస్ 56,000 వ్యూస్. ఓకే, ఎనివే వి షుడ్ స్టాప్ హియర్. టుమారో విల్ అగైన్ గెట్ బ్యాక్ టు అవర్ గ్రూప్ డిస్కషన్ అండ్ ఇంటర్వ్యూ ఎటిక్విటీ. ఓకే, ఎనీ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆర్ ఎనీ దిస్ థింగ్ క్వరీస్?